Okay, well, I had a little bit of trouble doing this last time. This time, let's see if I can get it perfectly on the first try. Let's see. I'll take it. What is going down, Niner Empire, Trash Talking Circle? It is your boy Danny G TV. As the Niners, well, they got a tough test against them. What, you say tough test? They're playing the Arizona Cardinals. The Arizona Cardinals are not a good team. You know what? I agree. They are not a good team. However, whenever we play them, they always play their hearts out, and they always fight with us until the end. And this is a team that, up until Halloween night, when I was there in person, they beaten us 8 straight times. 8 straight times. Unbelievable. And now, they're coming to our house after we finally snap that 8-game losing streak at their house. And I'll tell you what, the Arizona Cardinals are not particularly a good team, but they're also not a team that you can just easily beat. They have a horrible defense, but they have somewhat of a good offense, basically. Kyler Murray, in the game against us, he had 241 yards, 2 TDs. In the last game, Arizona played a 30-27 loss against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. He had 341 yards and 3 TDs. So he's a good young quarterback, still developing. But he's basically like Russell Wilson when he first started. He's basically like a mini Russell Wilson, a quarterback that can run with the ball, he can throw. Kind of also like a little bit like a Colin Kaepernick too in a way. However, I honestly think, as much as I love Cap, that he's going to end up having a better career in this league than Kaepernick. Does that mean I think he's going to take the Cardinals to the Super Bowl anytime soon? No, absolutely wrong. Do not think that that's what I mean, because that is not what I mean. But as a quarterback, I think he is going to have a good career. I think that, of course, this year the Cardinals are not going to make it to the playoffs. So facing us in our house, his first game facing us on the road, it's going to be a game that he's going to want to win. It's going to be the game the Cardinals are going to want to win. So the Niners, after that first loss against Seattle, this is a game that they're going to have to play as if it determines whether or not they're going to make the playoffs or not. This is a game that they're going to need to win in convincing fashion in order to prove that they are still one of the top teams in the NFL after losing to the Seahawks. And again, yes, the Niners could have beaten the Seahawks and started off 9-0 if rookie Chase McLaughlin would have made that game-winning field goal in overtime. But even despite that, if that would have happened, a bunch of things looked sloppy in that game against the Niners, and a bunch of things that they're going to have to fix in this game against the Cardinals. The drops were ridiculous. The drops were atrocious. The drops was the main reason why the Niners did not start off 9-0 on Monday night. Kendrick Bourne is going to have a bounce back game. Kendrick Bourne's going to have, I'm going to say, 4 receptions. George Kittle is questionable. He probably will not play, just like he did not play against Seattle. And you could tell how much of a toll that put on this Niners offense. when their biggest offensive threat was not playing, they were forced to go to Kendrick Bourne. We're forced to try to go to Dante Pettis. We're forced to try to go to Marquise Goodwin. And Emmanuel Sanders, when he got injured in the first half, he was their biggest receiving threat in the first quarter and the second quarter until he went down. He was their biggest offensive threat. Emmanuel Sanders is also unlikely to play on Sunday. He might play, but regardless of if he does or not, this passing game, Jimmy G is going to have to go downfield and actually complete a pass. He's going to have to do a better job scanning his receivers. Kendrick Bourne is going to have to hold on to the ball like he did somewhat in the game. He got that TD, got 3 receptions, I believe, completed that 2-point conversion. But he's going to have to not drop 50% of his intended passes as well, too. He's going to have to hold on to the ball. The running game. We're facing a Cardinals defense that is very bad. They have Chandler Jones, who's a beast. Buda Baker, who's all right. But overall, their defense is not good. Trust me. I know people here that talk about how bad the Cardinals defense is, because it truly is not a good defense at all. Chandler Jones is a beast. I expect him to have a couple sacks. But other than that, the Niners need to run. With Matt Breida out for a couple weeks, Tevin Coleman's going to have to run all over that weak Cardinals defense. He's going to have to run all over them. He's going to have to... I expect him to have a couple rushing TDs, just like he had 4 rushing TDs against the Panthers. I expect a big game from Tevin Coleman. I expect that this Niners defense is going to have a big game as well. I expect to see Nick Bosa have some sacks like we haven't seen in a little while from him. We have not seen a big sack performance from Bosa lately. I expect Eric Armstead, DeForest Buckner to be crucial in this game. DeForest Buckner is going to have a big game. I see him having some strip sacks against Murray, hopefully recovering some more fumbles. That's what I see from him. This defense needs to force turnovers like they did facing Russell Wilson and facing Seattle. They need to do the same thing against a mini Russell Wilson and Kyler Murray and David Johnson and this Cardinals offense. Now, the Cardinals have some good receivers. Of course, they have Larry Fitzgerald, who's arguably one of the greats of all time. And I have nothing but respect for Larry Fitzgerald for what he's been able to accomplish, but he's not having as good a year as he normally does. Andy Isabella got that touchdown against us to make it a close game. Keyshawn Johnson, who, just like me, moved from Palo Alto to Arizona. He had a TD against us. The Cardinals have good receivers. Also, Kenyon Drake, he's a beast as well. He had a good game against us. So, Richard Sherman and the Niners secondary need to be making plays. I want the Niners to win at least by 10 points. My score prediction is 20-10. I would much prefer for them to win by a bigger margin. But if they can at least win by 10 points, they can prove that they are still one of the top teams in this division. Debo Samuel, I expect to have a big game. I expect him to start off right from where he left off in the Seattle game. He was on fire. And Debo has had some crucial drops as well this game. He had one in overtime, and he's had one throughout the year. He's looked good when he wanted to. He's looked bad at times, too. I expect him to have a big game in this game, though. And overall, the Niners just cannot afford to lose this game if they want to still be in the hunt. Because if they lose this game somehow, not saying it's going to happen, if they lose this game, then, well, all the talk is going to be, were their first 8 games just a fluke? The Niners do not want that to be the discussion. The Niners do not want to be called pretenders. The Niners want to still be considered one of the top teams in the NFL. They damn well nearly beat the damn Seahawks at home. And now they need to beat the Cardinals and sweep the Cardinals at home. So, Jimmy Garoppolo, of course, after that loss, despite the fact that he had more passing yards than Russell Wilson, despite the fact that he did not look that bad, the drops against that he had in this that his receivers had in this in that game, and his incomplete passes where it just looked like he was throwing to nowhere in the pocket, those were what the critics saw. Now, Jimmy G had a big game the last time he faced this Arizona Cardinals team. He needs to prove that that was not a fluke. He needs to prove that he is not just a game manager, but also a franchise quarterback, and he needs to have a big game at home against the Arizona Cardinals. Danny G is out. That is all I got. Please check out my column. I posted it down below. I'm going to be writing a bunch of articles analyzing this Niners team. So check it out. Link is down below to my site. DG is out. Peace. Niner Empire. One team, one family, one goal. Let's get it.